Okay, you're probably thinking, what in the world is this guy doing today? This is a crazy way to start a Bible study. I have a sister that posts songs for her friends and coworkers every day. Sometimes I put in a request. This happened to be my request. And then she responded to that request saying, hey, this was an appropriate song. Because at the time that the OJs published this, recorded this song, there was a great deal of civil unrest in the world, and they were encouraging people to get together and to form a love train. We as Christians kind of stand, we kind of smirk at that and go, okay, love train, yeah. But to me, it is interesting that really that kind of thing, to some degree, is what we should be known for. Sadly, what most of us Christians are known for is how political we are, how much we rage against the system, how much we rage against our congressmen and our governors and our presidents and everybody else, and people that you people are like that, and we rage against that group of people because we don't like what they stand for and things like that. And this is what we as Christians are known for. And yet notice what Jesus says here. This is John 13. This is the night Jesus is betrayed. He's gathered with just the 11 now, because Judas has left the room a little while ago. He has taken a towel and put it around himself, gotten down on the floor, and done the menial task of washing the feet of the disciples. Wow. The master serving his disciples. And he then gives them this charge, this command. I give to you a new kind of command. It's new kind because this trumps the greatest command of the law. Because the measure of this love is not going to be yourself or what, everything you've got to give. It's loving one another as I've loved you, which means serving. No matter who you are, learn to serve others. You must also love one another. And notice verse 35, by this all people will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. Is that what we're known for? I've asked Christians this lots of times because I think about it myself. Because many of us as believers, as Christians, we tend to be very conservative. We're conservative in our politics. We're conservative in our values, our family perspectives. And that conservatism gets in the way oftentimes. And I'm not saying those are bad things. Do not misunderstand me. I'm not saying those are bad, but we let those things trump this. That's what we're known for. We're known for that, and then we're known for how frustrated we get and how much we express that frustration against the system. And whether it's when you talk with people or whether you're with some people on social media or whatever it is, that's the stuff that everybody sees of us. And yet Jesus says, you know, the thing that would let you be known, that would make you known as my disciple, is the love that you have for one another. Is that what people know? Is that what people see with us? I want to go to Colossians chapter 3. I want to go back up here to a verse that we have talked about before in verse 11, where he says, in Christ, there is no Greek or Jew, circumcision or uncircumcision, barbarian or Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and in all. It doesn't make any difference what your racial background is. Doesn't make any difference what your sex is. Doesn't make any difference what your previous religious status was. It doesn't make any difference how cultured or uncultured you are, educated or uneducated you are. None of those things matter. Because if you're in Christ, you're part of something altogether new and different. And Paul says, if you get that, then he gives this charge. Notice the practical point that he says, therefore, God's chosen ones, holy and loved, put on heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, accepting or putting up with one another. Are others different than you sometimes? Yes, that's okay. Don't worry about it. accepting or putting up with one another. And then this word that's forgive, this is even more powerful than forgive. It's actually a verb form of the word grace. Be gracious with yourselves. And if anyone has a complaint against another, just as God has been gracious with you, so also you be. In other words, be gracious with other people. They have some, they fuss with you. There's something maybe they don't like. Just be gracious. And then he says in verse 14, and above all of that, put on love, the perfect bond of unity. And this word bond of unity is literally the idea of a uniting chain. Paul, I think, had a unique perspective on this because he's under house arrest in Rome when he writes this. And every day, there's probably a new soldier that comes in, and that soldier takes the chain that was on the other soldier, locks it to his foot, and that chain is locked to Paul's foot, so that Paul is every day chained to a Roman soldier, and that unites them. That's the way he was under house arrest, most likely. And Paul talks about his chain. Now he uses this, and Paul looks at that chain and he goes, but you know, in a metaphorical way, love acts like a chain with us. It should bind us together. It should chain us together, not to chafe on our legs and going, oh man, I have to be chained to these people. No, but it's love. You want to be with those people. You want to share with those people. You want to demonstrate love to those. And this is what we should be known for. Brothers and sisters in Christ, we should be known for the kind of love for one another that's willing to say, you need something? Let me meet that need. Let me put the towel metaphorically around me and get down and serve you. Let me wash your feet. I don't care. There should be no task that we could do on behalf of another believer that we would ever deem as beneath us. I don't care who you are. You could be a pastor. You could be a leader in the church. You too are responsible. You have this privilege of loving one another. And this is what we should be known for. Plug this into your thinking. And maybe we could have a love chain of our own. And maybe if we demonstrated that, maybe other people out there in the world that are raging and frustrated and whatever they're dealing with might say, what is that kind of love over there? How do I have that? And God might grant us the privilege of telling them about the Lord Jesus Christ and how they could be also part of that family by believing in Him. Thank you for joining me today. Have a good day in the Lord.